Hey everyone, Dr. Brian Capra here from Genesis Chiropractic Software. Today I'm going to talk to you about how insurance companies are actually legally allowed to collude against us chiropractors, we chiropractors, to actually keep our money, gain interest on that money, and use that money to actually maybe even use it to audit more chiropractors, take even more money back from us. I'm sorry I'm coming to you a little bit late today. It's a little bit late and the lighting's a little off in my office today. Usually I have a lot of natural light in here, but today my son had an ear infection, got really bad pain. So if you have any, of course, got it adjusted, got the garlic drops, did the whole thing. He's doing much better, but if you have any other ways to handle that, please let me know. You can comment in this video. Anyway, so last video I talked to you about how insurance companies actually make more than 50% of their profit on interest on your money. So they should have paid you right after you adjust that patient. There's nothing technically in technology today preventing them from actually paying you at the time of service, yet they do not. And in most states, they have usually about 30 days to process a claim, not necessarily pay you, but process the claim, right? So they can deny you, they can put you through that whole rigmarole. So why is it that on Wall Street, way more complex transactions happen every single day, but yet it's the law that everybody involved in those transactions must be paid before the end of the day? Why is it that the law on Wall Street, but not for us or we? So there's a very simple answer to that, which I couldn't believe it when I found this out. It turns out that insurance companies are legally allowed to collude against physicians. So it's not really just us, it's everybody, every physician, the entire healthcare profession or industry. Insurance companies are allowed to collude. We've heard a lot about collusion these days, right? In politics, this is actually real collusion. This actually happens and it's by law, it's on the books. It's no secret out there. As a matter of fact, if doctors were to all get together, if every chiropractor in the country were to get together and say, from now on, adjustment is for whatever code is $60 and we will never take less, that's actually illegal. That's called a monopoly, right? And you may remember Microsoft went through a massive, what's called antitrust case back in the day when they were seen as having a monopoly on the personal computing world, right? It's a real thing in a capitalist economy that a company by law cannot monopolize an industry. They can't be the only provider of a good or service. And once they do that, they have so much power that they have full power over dictating the price of that good or service. So that's against the law. It's called antitrust law. It's very well documented. You can Google it and you'll find a million different antitrust cases. It's very important for it to be there in our economy. So what insurance companies have done is the opposite of what is a monopoly. A monopoly, again, is provide as being the only provider of a good or a service or product or whatever, what have you. Insurance companies are the opposite of that. There's a word for it. It's called an oligopoly. Google it, oligopoly. And what you'll notice is that that's when there's only one buyer of a good or a service. Right now, over 70% of lives in this country are covered by three insurance plans. And you'll probably know if you've done any reading on this, every time a little insurance company pops up, they get gobbled up by one of the big dogs out there. And in doing so, since there's only one buyer out there of chiropractic adjustments, if you would, one payer, they dictate the price of an adjustment. And obviously you've seen what happens when that's the case, your payment or reimbursement continues to go down over time. God only knows what would happen if we had a single payer system and left it all up to the government. Because here's what's actually happened. So we want to know why we don't get paid right after our adjustment when technically that could happen and probably save everybody a whole lot of money. And why that insurance companies want to be able to wait 30 days to process a claim and then have a denial process and hopefully you never remember to get that claim to follow up on denials. Hopefully they make the process so complicated you never even submit the claim to begin with. That's actually happening. We're going to get more into the tactics that they actually use to make to drag out the timeline for a claim to be processed in my next video and go into very specific tactics. In this video, what I want you to understand is that It's actually legal for insurance companies to collude. Why do they want to collude? They want to control the market, gain the profit, and continue to use that money to reinvest in their own company and in lobbies. Once they have the lobbies, once they have the collusion and the power, they lobby to gain the law, and actually, legally, in 1945, gained one of the only industry or one of the only industries exempt from antitrust law. So insurance companies are one of the few and only industries in the country that are exempt from collusion, the antitrust laws that everybody else and every other company has to abide by, including chiropractors and physicians. All physicians across the country cannot do what insurance companies do to us. It's a pretty amazing fact. So what do? They can collude, they consolidate, they collude by consolidation and gain power. Once they gain the power, they can write the law, basically. They can write the laws and the guidelines on how claims are processed in this country. So this whole thing starts to become a little bit more clear that how they make their money is on profit, and how they've gained so much power is by colluding against us, the healthcare industry, to gain the power to make the rules for claim processing. And if you think cash kind of protects you from this, there's actually something more to that. Even cash, or going cash, actually doesn't protect you. And that'll be a later video. I'll go into how going cash, and just when you thought you're out, they pull you back in. And it's not even the insurance companies at that point. It's a lot of state boards and things like that, where you could wind up in more trouble or have worse ramifications than accepting insurance. So I'm going to go into all that, but just want to make sure you understood tonight that insurance companies are legally allowed by law. This government, our country, our government has given them the power to collude against us legally. Next video, I'm going to go over the actual tactics. So now they've got the power. You know, we know how they make their money. We know how they got their power to rig this whole system, if you would. And now we're going to go into some more specific details of, now they got the power, what are the tactics they use to actually keep your money even longer, to gain that interest? And then obviously, once they have that money, not only investing in lobbies, but they're investing in audits. There's a 14-to-1 return on investment. Every dollar they invest in an audit, they get $14 back. So we'll go into a lot more detail in future videos, but right now I just wanted to quickly get this video out to you, hopefully not too late tonight. So thank you so much, guys. I'll see you on the next video.